Here's a check on stories we're following for you today on Robinhood Radio. Pat Pagano's Tri-State Forecast calls for a partly sunny day today, lower 40s, turning cloudy tonight, mid-20s. We've got some snow or snow showers possible tomorrow, lower 30s. Thursday, snow showers, then partly sunny, mid-30s. Friday, cloudy, snow and rain showers, 40 to 45 degrees. We'll get the full details on our Tri-State Forecast coming your way in just a few minutes. Once again, yesterday, a notice went out from Region 1 about COVID-19 in Cornwall, Kent, Salisbury, and Sharon. In Cornwall, two family members of Consolidated School students tested positive for COVID-19. Those family members have never been in the building and have had no close contact within 3 feet in the classroom. So the students or staff that are sick will stay home. The affected individuals of all family members will remain in isolation. A staff member at Kent Center School tested positive for coronavirus. The staff member was last in the building on Monday, December 6th. No close contact within 6 feet for 15 minutes or longer was identified at the school. The affected staff member will remain at home in quarantine. A staff member at Salisbury Central School tested positive for COVID-19. That member was last in the building on Thursday, December 2nd. No close contacts once again were identified. That person will quarantine. And a staff member at Sharon Center School tested positive for coronavirus. The staff member was last in the building on December 3rd. All close contacts once again have been notified. They will follow the screen and stay protocol quarantine as recommended by the Connecticut Department of Public Health. The affected staff member will remain at home in isolation. In Connecticut, meanwhile, the state remains in red with hospitalizations now hitting 500. The governor's office reported yesterday the number of people hospitalized with COVID-19 rose over the weekend to 500 just 5 months after dropping to a low of 25. That includes a rise of 20 coronavirus-related hospitalizations since Friday, according to the state. Lamont, speaking before the latest numbers were released, credited vaccinations and boosters with trying to keep hospitalizations down. In New York State, some counties are lagging behind in COVID-19 vaccinations for 5 to 11. About 275,000 children, or about 18% of New Yorkers in the 5 to 11 group, have received their first dose, but nearly 40 of the 62 counties statewide fell below that rate, according to state data, which was released on Friday. Berkshire COVID-19 cases have risen by 226 over 3 days. As of Monday, there were 226 newly confirmed COVID-19 cases in Berkshire County over 3 days for a 7-day rolling average of 88 new daily cases, a 37% increase from 2 weeks ago. Hurricane Ida impacted New Yorkers now have more time to apply for FEMA help with storm damage. They have a few more weeks to seek federal money. The Federal Emergency Management Agency extended the deadline to January 4th to apply for individual assistance. January 4th is also the deadline to apply for a disaster loan from the U.S. Small Business Administration. People can apply for FEMA assistance and disasterassistance.gov through the FEMA mobile app or via the FEMA helpline at 800-621-3362. Helpline operators are available from 7 to 11 daily. Meanwhile, tomorrow from 6 till 7 p.m. on Zoom, Sharon Connect will update community on high-speed internet possibilities for the town. You can join them on Zoom tomorrow to hear the update on the work being done to map out possible town-owned high-speed networks, although a final analysis won't be completed until mid-January. And if you need that link is https://us02web.zoom.us/j/87448-54583. So meetings coming up this week in our area. The Rose Thrift Shop, located in the basement of the Immaculate Conception Church at Amenium, will have their bag sale today and then Saturday from 10 a.m. till 2 p.m. The shop will then close for the season at the end of the day on Saturday. In Sharon, the Planning and Zoning Commission meets at 5:30, and the Sewer and Water Commission meets at 7 p.m. In Cornwall, housing plan hearing is at 7 p.m. via Zoom. Falls Village at 7 p.m., the Recreation Commission. Planning Board meeting will be held on Wednesday in Sheffield at 7 p.m. via Zoom. Also on Wednesday, the Town of Northeast Planning Board has their revised agenda for their meeting at 7:30 p.m. Coming up on Thursday in Falls Village, the P&Z has a special meeting at 6:30. In Salisbury on Friday, December 10th at 8:30, a special meeting of the PZC and the Inland Wetlands Commission. It's Winterfest at the Maplebrook School main campus December 10th from 6 to 8 p.m. and December 11th from 10 a.m. till 8 p.m. Bring a new hat, scarf, or mittens for admission. Proceeds benefit Adopt a Family. Walk through the campus winter wonderland, holiday gifts for purchase, food, drink, caroling, and you can even meet Santa. Now, coming up at the Sharon Playhouse on Saturday, December 11th at 2 and 7 p.m. and Sunday, December 12th at 3 p.m., It's a Wonderful Life, a live radio play. Both performances will be in the Bach Gallery. Proof of vaccination for all shows is required. 860-364-7469, sharonplayhouse.org. And COVID-19 vaccines are coming to your neighborhood. The town of North Canaan, 100 P Street, Sunday, December 12th from 10 till 4. Northwest corner residents only. Walk-in, no appointment needed. No ID or insurance required. 5 to 11 years only. Must be accompanied by a parent or legal guardian. Pfizer vaccine. For more information, call 211 or visit on the web ct.gov/COVID-vaccine. Opening night festivities on December 11th from 4 to 6 p.m. in Cornwall, West Cornwall, Connecticut. You can explore an all-new walkable outdoor art gallery inspired by the 12 Days of Christmas. It's open for the second year with all new works of art by new and returning artists. The sidewalks of West Cornwall will transform into a walking art gallery as artists create unique interpretations of the timeless 12 Days of Christmas holiday theme. Windows nestled throughout the picturesque West Cornwall village area, all within easy walking distance of one another. No more than a half hour is needed to see all the windows and shop in local shops. Younger guests can collect stickers at each artist's window and even get a prize if they collect all 12. The exhibition is open for exploration from Saturday, December 11th until Sunday, January 2nd. You can view it at any time. The Village of Millerton has their next regular meeting on Monday, December 13th at 6 p.m. That is a change date from the December 20th date due to the holiday. Our business brief is underwritten by Morgan's at the Interlaken, interlakenin.com. They've got a great new tapas menu added, and also you can find them on Facebook and Instagram. And by Salisbury Bank, salisburybank.com. The Dow Jones Industrial Average will start off the day today at 35,227.03. The NASDAQ at 15,225.15. And the S&P 500 at 4,591.67. We'll check the forecast in just a few minutes.